MLB Network is your exclusive home for postseason baseball. It's Game 3 of the National League Division Series between the LA Dodgers and the Washington Nationals. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vasgersian welcoming you to our exclusive postseason coverage on MLB Network. Homeside about to take the field. This place is jumping. Here's public address announcer Alex Miniak. Time now to check out the lineup for the visiting Dodgers. Dero, what's your take on this lineup as they look to lock up the division series?
Matt, you take a look at this lineup, I find myself thinking back to my playing days when I knew I had the ace on the mound. It had to be win day, and when you get in a car to drive to the yard, you tell yourself, even though you felt bad about it, just get two or three. All the pressure's on the big boy to have to execute, and he usually does. Look for this lineup to try and execute and score, manufacture one or two runs early in this one.
2-2 to the Dodgers catcher.
Yeah, and if you get a guy flailing at a pitch like that, heck, you're going to go out there and throw that same pitch till he proves he can lay off of it.
Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch, and it's fouled away. Here's the pitch on 2-2. And he takes strike three called on the fastball, and the leadoff man is gone to start the evening.
One thing to know is not all strikeouts are created equal. Right there, he goes down on strikes, but he really made that guy on the mound work for it. And when you're doing that in the first inning, it can have an effect on how deep he's going to be able to go into this start. There's a big difference between that and going down on three or four pitches.
So the base is empty here with one away, and that'll bring up the third baseman, Justin Turner. This one's down to third, fielded by Rendon. On to first, and Sanchez has got it working now. There are two away. So bases are empty here with two gone, and that brings in the former World Series hero, David Freese. Slow little grounder left side. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Dodgers down in order, and now the Nationals get their first opportunity. No score. Time now from our nation's capital to take a look at the Nats starting lineup. Dero, tell us about this lineup as they try to keep their playoff hopes alive.
Matty, I love the way this lineup's constructed. Talking to the manager before the game, he focused on the fact that they have a pass the baton mentality. Everything's flowing for this lineup. Chance to score a lot of runs.
Hyunjin Ryu is on the mound, and he'll look to wrap up this division series. Dan, any thoughts?
Well, Matt, he reminds me, he's the closest thing that I've seen to David Wells. You watch him throw, he's 89 to 93 miles an hour, kind of a big, loopy, overhand curveball, does have the hard slider and the changeup. A good athlete for a big guy. You'll know if he's on early. He has to get his breaking pitches over to make his fastball effective.
All right, guys, here's the defensive alignment for the Los Angeles Dodgers. And the guy behind the dish today, Canadian-born Russell Martin. He's been a catcher his entire career, but I'll tell you what, some of the softest hands in the game, this guy could easily play an infield position, and he wouldn't skip a beat.
The speedy Trey Turner digs in now. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Peterson is right there as he puts it away. No problem for the first out. Stepping in, Adam Eaton, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Now the 2-1 is laid off of for ball number three.
Down to 3-1.
Anthony Rendon is on deck. Bases are empty, one man out. He'll try to bunt his way on as he gets this one down. Throw not in time, and that'll go as a bunt single. Now to the plate, Anthony Rendon. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Here now the 2-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
In a double play situation, you kind of expect most pitches to be down in the zone, hoping for a ground ball. So that was an interesting pitch selection to go up in the zone. I think he caught him off guard a little bit.
Eaton is off of first with two away. And he fouls this one off. The 1-2. In the dirt here. And just what they wanted offensively as the runner moves into scoring position.
That was definitely a two-strike curveball there. The catcher turns his glove over and tries to make himself big to block it, but with no luck. The ball skips away, and it scored a wild pitch.
Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2.
Now on 3-2 as a pitcher, you've got to go with the pitch that you feel most comfortable throwing with.
Here's the payoff pitch. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Peterson has a read on it. Makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. One left for Washington, and this is still a nothing-nothing ball game. And next will be the Dodgers' cleanup hitter, Kike Hernandez. He'll get us started in the top of the second. Now the 1-1 pitch. One ball and two strikes to count. Hit the other way out toward right field. And this will be pulled in just in front of the warning track for the first out. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And up next, the center fielder, A.J. Pollock. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two.
Boy, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, you have to make sure it's up above the zone like that. He can't do a whole lot with that, but if it were a little lower, he can and will make you pay big time.
Lifted in the air out to right. Eaton on the move, but he won't get to it. It drops in behind him.
That was a great job of driving that ball, extending his arms very well, was able to get it over the right fielder's head, one hopping it off the wall for an easy double. That's one of those solid hits that you don't even feel coming off the bat.
Into the box now, Jock Peterson. This one's outside, quite a bit off the plate that time. So let's take a look at our umpiring crew in this one. Behind the plate is Joe McDonald.
You know, you got to take your time and feel Joe McDonald out behind the dish a little bit. He has a tendency to move his zone around, usually settling in those middle innings.
You know, all you ask for an umpire is to be consistent. At times, Joe Mack is a little bit too inconsistent, particularly from a pitcher standpoint. And with first base open, the last thing he wanted to do was give him something to hit in the heart of the zone. So no harm done. Force out anywhere now.
Coming to the plate now, Corey Seager. And he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here. Two balls and two strikes to Corey Seager. And that's lifted the other way out to left. Soto is there. Two down. So two on with two away, and that brings in the former National League Rookie of the Year, Cody Bellinger. This is lined to left, and that's going to get down out there. And the run will score as the Dodgers grab the early 1-0 lead.
Boy, that has to feel good as a hitter, D-Roy. You get that base hit to give your team the lead. You have to feel good when you get down to first base.
Yeah, it's just a nice approach. You see him turn to his boys right there and get fired up with the dugout. 100%. Not trying to do too much. Able to quiet the moment down, center himself, and come through in a big spot.
In now, Hyunjin Ryu. A right back to him on the mound. And they will get the force at third, and that's that. Only one in the inning here for the guys in blue. On now to the bottom of the second. The Dodgers lead it 1-0. So striding in, Howie Kendrick, as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 here to start the home half of the second. One-one. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Pollock giving chase. And a great diving effort there, but it'll just tip off his glove, and it's a base hit. Now batting, Kurt Suzuki. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Just flat out froze him there. Nothing too deceptive about that four-seam fastball, so I think he wasn't expecting it at all.
Stepping in now, Brian Dozier. Two balls and a strike to Dozier.
The intent with that changeup away was one thing and one thing only. Get a double play ball. Nice job to lay off it at the plate, though.
Come on, Brian.
Takes this the other way to right. Bellinger is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. So the runner at first here with two gone in the inning. And that means batting next will be the center fielder, Michael A. Taylor. The 1-2. Is laid off for ball two. Nice.
first with two gone. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Pollock on the run. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. Nationals leave one. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Next up for Los Angeles, Russell Martin, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. And a swing and a miss from Martin as he'll retreat to the dugout is out number one.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing at that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
Into the box, Justin Turner. High in the air out to center field. Taylor is there now, and he has it, two gone.
MVP.
In now, David Freese. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Two out, nobody on. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now. The 3-2 pitch, and this misses for ball four, the second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings. So here's the cleanup hitter, Kike Hernandez. He flew out in his last at bat. The 1-1. 1-2 now. Two out with the man at first. Now a fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at 2-2. And a splitter here, but he had a bit too much on it as this bounces up to the plate.
Good running count right here. Three balls, two strikes, two outs, runner on first. He'll be off to the races on this pitch.
Count still full, 3-2. The next 3-2. And he misses again, ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball.
Oh, man, I think this walk is going to grind at him for a bit. He just missed, and now the inning continues with the man in scoring position.
Trying to pick things up where he left off, A.J. Pollock. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get. Maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
Beat LA.
ground ball sent back up the middle. There is Dozier on to first, and the Dodgers come up with nothing as that ends the inning. A couple of walks, but no damage. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. Now to the plate, the pitcher, Anibal Sanchez. Hit back up the middle. And that is through into center, a base hit, and the opposing pitcher gets aboard to kick off the inning.
Hey, this is perfect storm right here. This is how big innings start. You put a crooked number up on the board when the pitcher leads off an inning with a huge knock.
Into the box now, Trey Turner, line towards center field. Pollock is there, and he has it for the first out. In now is Adam Eaton. One and two now to Adam Eaton.
You could clearly see that the hitter didn't like that strike call, and his manager, he didn't like it either, as he's given the umpire an earful from that dugout.
From the stretch. Line drive, base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
A lot of traffic hitting the base pass. First and second with one out. I know you're looking for a double play ball, Dan.
No question about it. I think one of the things you like to do on a pitcher is try to jump on him early before he gets settled in. So far, so good. First and second. Looks like a big inning could be brewing.
Standing in now, Anthony Rendon.
That's ball three.
Ball three.
You can bet he's salivating a little in the box right now. He likes to drive in runs, and he's got a great situation and count to do that right here.
Here comes the 3-1 pitch. Line down the left field line. But this is foul near the seats. Sanchez over at second. Eaton is over at first with one away. Line drive to left. Peterson will range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the second out of the inning. Striding in now for the Nats, Juan Soto, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. The set and the 1-1. Changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now. That's lifted the other way out to left. Peterson has a read on it. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. So it's no runs on two hits, no errors, and two men left stranded. Game three moves forward to the fourth inning now. It's the Dodgers 1 and the Nationals nothing. And back in our nation's capital, before we get too much further on the field, let's check in with Heidi.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. They've already worked out three walks, so he feels as though that kind of willingness to let the opposition work themselves into trouble will continue to result in good things for them on the scoreboard.
All right, thanks, Heidi. Here's Jock Peterson now. He drew a base on balls his first time up.
MVP!
below the zone, a swing and a miss.
Offered at that breaking ball below the zone, and that's a tough one to spit on. But the key is recognizing it coming out of the pitcher's hand earlier and making sure that it goes up before it comes down. More likely to be a hanger when that's the case.
Lined into right, a base hit. So the fourth inning opens with a leadoff single. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
It was pretty obvious in live action that that ball was hit hard, and after analyzing it with our show track technology, we see that our eyes did not deceive us. 114 miles an hour was the exit velo, an impressive swing of the bat.
In now, Corey Seager. Breaking ball snaps in there for a called strike two. Fouled away. One run on three hits. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. And it's a productive first out as that runner is able to advance 90 feet up to third here. Now at the plate, Cody Bellinger. He singled his last time up.
Yeah, and he's got to feel super confident right now. He's the only real offense in this game. Guys on the mound have been executing every pitch.
And he takes ball two, and it's two and one. Here's the 2-1. It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. And he pushed it just a bit too much. It'll wind up a foul ball. The 2-2 pitch is a fastball down below the knees. Sanchez coming up on pitch number 71 so far. He got him, and it'll probably take a base hit now to get that runner across from third.
That strikeout changes the whole complexion of the inning. He was definitely pitching for it with a runner on third and one out, and he got it. Now it's going to take a hit or something like a wild pitch to get that guy home.
Into the box, Hyunjin Ryu, Dodgers pitcher, trying to deal with a 1-2 count at the plate.
Hey, I know it's the pitcher at the plate, but he's going to grind it out right here. He's got a chance to help himself, and nothing's a bigger backbreaker to a team than watching the pitcher drive in a run.
Hit on the ground to third. Rendon is there. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. One left for L.A., but they're up 1-0. For Washington, Howie Kendrick. He set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning. A bouncer up the middle. Throws in time, and that's out number one. Digging in, Kurt Suzuki. He got called out on strikes his last time through.
Yeah, Matty, and he was locked up by a good fastball for strike three last time. I'm interested to see if they attack him the same way. Come at him with hard velo late or snap something off in the dirt to see if he'll fish.
Peterson will range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the second out of the inning. Here's Brian Dozier now. He's 0 for 1 thus far. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. Got a piece, it's 2-2. No runs, 4 hits, and no errors so far for the Nationals. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2. Michael Taylor would be next. Looking to fade his first walk. Here it comes. Swing and a miss got him reaching. And that ends the inning. Pretty painless half of the inning all told. On to the top of inning number 5 we go. It's the Dodgers 1 and the Nationals nothing. Wander Suero, the 6'4" right-hander, comes in out of the bullpen to do the pitching. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Russell Martin. He's hoping to avoid the hat trick. He struck out in each of his first 2 plate appearances so far. The 1-1 misses, ball 2.
We've seen him go down on strikes more than once in this game, so this has been a better approach by him at this at bat. Much more patient, and he's gotten himself into a good hitter's count.
Come on now. Right here.
2-2 now. Action now in the Washington bullpen as a right-hander begins to get loose. A 2-2 count. Here's the pitch. And he struck out again. That's the 3rd time he's gone down on strikes in this one. What's your take on all the strikeouts we see in the game today, Dan? That was his 3rd tonight, and it seems we're seeing that a lot more these days.
Yeah, Matt, there's been a real change in philosophy as far as hitting in baseball today. A lot of guys think now that an out is an out, a strikeout is just as good as a regular out, but we're seeing strikeouts at an alarming rate in baseball right now.
Into the box now, Justin Turner. Swing and a miss on the cut fastball, 1-2. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are 2 gone.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
Stepping up now, David Freese. First 2 men in the inning have both gone down via the punch-out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. Now the payoff pitch home. Gets him looking. Strike 3. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers, but they hold a 1-0 lead. Welcome back for the bottom of the 5th. Here's Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Nationals manager Dave Martinez between innings, specifically about his club's offense to this point. And he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said they've been chasing at pitches out of the zone all game, which obviously doesn't usually lead to good results. Until they start being more selective with their swings, he said they will continue to struggle.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. The 1-1 home. taken. Strike two. The 1-2. Is a swing and a miss. That's strike three.
This guy is really locked in on the bump right now. He's just playing good old-fashioned hardball right now, just rearing back and letting it go. And it seems like this lineup, they don't have an answer for anything he's bringing so far.
Ryan Zimmerman will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here. The 1-2. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. Another 1-2 delivery. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
Two up, two down on strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
Ready once again, Trey Turner. Two away in the inning, and Dan, it looks like this could be another 1-2-3 inning for him.
Yeah, he has really found a groove on the mound, and it's been impressive to watch. It'll be interesting to see how long he can keep this dominance up.
Line to the right side, and he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Nationals gone in order. They're down 1-0. Tanner Rainey takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Kike Hernandez. Due up for the 4, 5, and 6 hitters, and they're hoping that this is the part of the lineup that can get something going.
Yeah, only one run on the board so far for them. They just haven't had consistently good at-bats.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Into the corner and slicing foul. Here now the 2-2 and another foul ball.
I don't think he's going to triple up on changeup right there. He seemed to have gotten the timing down on that second one.
And oh, he can't get out of the way of that one. So the leadoff man will be on to open the frame.
Yeah, I can hear the crowd murmuring now, wondering if he hit him on purpose. But hey, us pitchers need to be able to throw inside, especially when facing hitters as dangerous as he is. Pretty sure this one just got away from him. And hey, that's part of the game.
Standing in, A.J. Pollock, 1-for-2 with a double on the ledger so far. One pitch, and he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away.
Let's get down here.
And here's a ball hit in the air. Eaton sprinting after it, but this will land untouched. Hernandez gets his lead at first, nobody out. Grounded to the right. And that finds its way through for a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
You know, as a former infielder, Danny, they always say you can't be in two places at once, but you got to be a little frustrated right here that ball found the hole.
Yeah, that's a tough thing. You make a quality pitch and a guy shoots one through the right side, normally a vacated spot right there. 9 out of 10 times, somebody's there to make that play. Unfortunately, not, and now we've got a couple of guys on.
Fouled off. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Taylor comes on now and he has it, one down. And the runner, not tagging, will retreat to second base. Coming to the plate now, Corey Seager. He was retired via the ground ball last time up.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result. That's his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
A ball and two strikes now. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Late on that one as it's fouled off to the left side. Now another 1-2. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. One, two is an off-speed pitch. No dice. It's 2-2. Hits are now even at 4 apiece. A swing, and he pops him up on the infield, and the infield fly rule will be in effect here. Into the box, Cody Bellinger, 1-for-2. He singled and struck out in 2 trips.
Let's go, Nationals. Come on.
Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. High in the air out to center field. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Dodgers strand a couple. They lead it 1-0. Leading off the inning, Adam Eaton, and they'll need him to get something going here. The 1-2 is looked at for ball number two. Line to shortstop, and there's one away. In now is Anthony Rendon. Here now the 2-2. And it's fouled away. One out, nobody on. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Hit hard on the ground towards second. Hernandez has it. Throw gets him. 2 down. Juan Soto to the plate now. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB. Hey, he's been able to pound that zone all night, working that outer half of the plate. That's why he's having so much success.
The 1-2 is taken for ball two.
Pretty standard curve in the dirt, looking for a strikeout there, but that was a good job of recognizing it and holding back at the plate.
This is in the air to center. Does he have another 1-2-3 for the Ledger? And Pollock will make the catch, and that ends the inning. Three up, three down for Washington. They trail this one 1-0. Back here at Nationals Park, on to the seventh now in game three. But before it gets underway, we take a look at our game summary through the first six. Daniel Hudson is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven. So stepping in, Hyunjin Ryu will get the first crack at it in the inning for LA. Russell Martin on deck to follow. Now the 1-1 pitch. And he fouls this one off.
When that thing goes whistling into the stands, you hope someone brought their glove and is able to get leather on it.
The 1-2 is a sinker that dips below the zone for a ball.
Well, these are just extra pitches that are just going to add to your pitch count. He's not trying to work around him, and no reason to, but sometimes you just lose the strike zone for no apparent reason.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. The 2-2 one more time. Fouled away. Him up. Kendrick over to his left. He's got it one away. Russell Martin now. Three at bats for him in this one, all ending with him going down on strikes. Now the 2-1 will not catch the zone. Ball three. Action in the bullpen now as a right-hander begins to throw out there. Bases are empty, one man out. And he'll strike out here yet again, as it's been a ball game to forget thus far. Four strikeouts.
Wow, he's just a lost cause in this one. That's the fourth time he struck out in this game alone, and that's not something you'll forget very quickly. That's about as bad of a day as you can have.
Standing in now, Justin Turner. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Now a fastball taken outside here as it moves it to 2-2 now. The 2-2. Line drive to left. Soto is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Dodgers down in order, but they lead it 1-0. Here's Howie Kendrick.
Starting to run out of time. They haven't been able to score any runs as we're moving late into this one. A perfect time for this leadoff guy to try to get on base and ignite a rally.
The 1-1. Line drive to left. Peterson is there, and he makes the catch for the out.
Boy, talk about hitting into some rough luck. That was an absolute bullet to the outfield that gets caught, and he would have represented a tying run.
In now, Kurt Suzuki. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. You're short, hit hard. Seager right there on the first, and Suzuki's retired, two away. So coming to the plate, Brian Dozier. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. The 1-1. Fouled straight back. The 1-2. Just hung in there on that one. Bases are empty here with two men out. This is hit out to right. Does he have another 1-2-3 inning? He sure does. Make it 14 in a row set down now. Carving him up as the side is retired. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. A new pitcher to tell you about now is it'll be the hard-throwing Fernando Rodney that gets the nod here. Here's David Freese to stand in. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Now the 1-1 pitch. Misses for the second ball. He pops it up, drifting just beyond the infield. Therefore, it is Dozier, and that's the first down. Pitching certainly has been on display in this one, and there's the evidence of it right there. 1-0 our score, as there are an awful lot of zeros on that line score to this point. Now at the plate, Kike Hernandez. Last time up, he was hit by a pitch.
Yeah, Matty, you're not lying. Last time up, squared right in the back. Hopefully it doesn't stiffen up. I want to see if he can get through something right here.
Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. Digging in and looking for more,
A.J. Pollock.
He steps in off a base hit in his last at-bat. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Right-hander starts to loosen out in the bullpen now. Two out, nobody on. Called strike two. And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers, but they're on top 1-0. So digging in now, Michael Taylor. He flew out his first time around and then was a strikeout victim most recently.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by one. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
Wisely lays off the cut fastball there. It's 2-1. Too high that time, and it's 3-1.
Great AB so far. I'd really like to see this guy work a walk and get on base for this team. Maybe give them a shot of confidence that they got a shot to get back in this one.
And a full count, 3-2 to Michael Taylor.
We got 3-2.
Payoff pitch one more time. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. The next 3-2. And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate.
Hey, this is a heck of a battle right here. Long AB. You know what? They find themselves still facing a starter. If they would have had some ABs like this earlier in the game, I think they get into the bullpen by this time.
And he rolls over this one foul. We'll do it once more. 3-2. No walks yet. Here's the delivery. Now a ball lying toward the alley in left center. Peterson will range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the first down.
Good contact to start out the inning. Thought he might be on base with some sort of a hit, but it hung up there too long. Just unlucky that time.
Now here's the Dodgers skipper up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And that will be the last we see in this one of Hyunjin Ryu. So as he leaves with the bases empty, he stands to be the winning pitcher here tonight if the bullpen can hold up the one-run lead. Joe Kelly answers the call now, looking to get this one onto the ninth inning without any trouble. Stepping in now, Yan Gomes. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two. Final line there for the Dodgers starting pitcher, and he really delivered a fantastic postseason performance.
One of the big keys to having a good pitching performance is not being afraid to throw the ball into the strike zone. And this guy certainly wasn't. And this one didn't allow a walk all game long.
The 1-1 home. Hit sharply on the ground to the left. And that's through for his first base hit in this one.
He looked a little bit out in front right there, but he's able to pull that ground ball through the hole for a single.
So they'll make a matchup move here and bring on a southpaw to face the left-handed hitter due up. Quick check on that tying run at first. Back in standing. Turner leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Into the box now, Adam Eaton. Pulled toward right center field. Bellinger is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. One left for Washington. It remains 1-0. Jock Peterson. He doubled earlier in the game, 1-for-2 to this point. And here's one that's taken for a ball. It's now 2-1 to the Dodger left fielder. Here now the 2-2 is laid off and the count runs full. And a swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here on the ninth.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best two-strike approach either.
Into the box, Corey Seager. This is line to left, and the catch is made there. Two gone here in the ninth.
Boy, sometimes they say you hit it hard and good things will happen. Well, that's not the case right there. That was a bullet that just stayed up and is caught in the outfield.
Standing in now, Cody Bellinger. Full count to Bellinger, 3 balls, 2 strikes. There's a swing and a high deep drive headed for the right field corner. But this one will bend foul. Had plenty of distance though as it landed in the upper deck. The 3-2 one more time. It's the top of the zone. He struck him out looking. Dodgers down in order, but they're up 1-0. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Kenley Jansen enters the game to finish this one off here in the bottom of the ninth. Plate, Anthony Rendon. And then what's gone wrong for this lineup today? They're only 3 outs away from being shut out.
Boy, you know, I just haven't seen a lot of fight in these at-bats. Now, of course, plenty of credit goes to that pitching, but the effort on the offensive side has been pretty lethargic watching from up here in the booth, Matt.
Yeah, I would imagine it feels the same from watching in the stands in this one. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Full count now, 3-2. Juan Soto will be next. Now the 3-2 pitch. And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Juan Soto. No thump out of him in this game so far, as might be expected. He's 0 for 3. The 1-1 pitch. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Peterson has a read on it, and that's the second out of the inning. Striding in, Howie Kendrick hit the ball pretty well in his last at-bat, but it resulted in a line out.
Yeah, Matty, but as he walks to the plate right here, he feels good building off that last AB. He hit that ball on the screws.
Last strike now for the Nats. Hit the other way out toward right field. Long run for the right fielder. And the Dodgers are going to advance. They're through to the National League Championship Series.
Well, my advice to them is to enjoy this moment, celebrate with teammates, and then realize that none of it will matter if they don't get back to work in the NLCS. They've wet their beaks with this postseason success. Now they want some more.
Well, we watched a really solid starting pitching performance, kept the opposition at bay, and as a result, he's our top player of the game.
Well, I was impressed by this outing, no doubt. The numbers don't lie. 7 1/3, very solid innings. And when you do that, you give your team a good chance to win a ball game.
For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our hardworking crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been the National League Division Series.